Hi everyone, what's up? It's Joshua here from Alternative Brewing. And today we're gonna be brewing espresso using the Flair 58 manual lever espresso machine. And this is the full package you get right here, which now includes the Flair 58 puck screen as standard issue. And this makes all the difference come extraction time, as well as the cleanup routine. Much more on that in a bit. But if you haven't already hit that like button, well, what are you waiting for? This is gonna let us know that you enjoy the videos that we post up each week, and not to miss one of them, hit that subscribe button and come along for the ride. Now let's check out the Flair 58. Much like its predecessors, is assembled from two main parts. The base, that's screwed tightly to the stem and the lever mechanism. And then you add the brew chamber in place, which is a semi-permanent fixture, and it screws in nice and secure. This is followed by the retractable piston that also contains the pressure gauge. Then all we have to do is add the drip tray, and it's almost done. Now, the last part of this setup is to connect the Flair 58 to electricity. And there are two versions of the Flair 58. There's the Flair 58X, which has no heating element, and you would preheat your brew head manually. Whereas the Flair 58 has a temperature selector that you plug in from the unit to the wall. And then once turned on, it's going to give you three distinct temperature settings for preheating your brew head electronically. That first setting is around 85 degrees Celsius, and this is great if you were brewing with a dark roasted coffee. The second is at around 90 degrees Celsius, which is good for a medium roast, and that third setting is in the mid to high 90s, which is the hottest range, and this is ideal for any lighter styles of roasted coffee. But you can also preheat the Flair 58 without electricity, as it comes with an open cap, and then you sit the group head over an open kettle to heat it, similar in the way in which you would preheat the Flair 58X. Now these preset temperatures are dependent on your ambient room temperature as well. And also in preheating the element, it doesn't work to heat water up within the brew group, so we still need to boil our water in a kettle first. Though this measure of electrical preheating does ensure that that brew water isn't losing a temperature too fast as you begin to add it into the brew group. And it's for this reason, I would almost recommend without fail using the hottest temperature setting available, regardless of what temperature of water you're going to be brewing with. You want to add your portafilter to the group whilst it's heating up, and I add the puck screen in there as well for the same reason. Now, I would happily have this warming up for 5 to 10 minutes to ensure it's all adequately at a stable temperature, but it will also beep once it has reached that temperature within the group. And then there's nothing really stopping you from going straight out of the gates to begin brewing if it's at that temp. Now, one of the most enjoyable aspects of the Flair 58 is the size of the portafilter and its filter basket. At 58 millimeters, which is basically the known standard for 95% of espresso machines, this allows for a lot more flexibility with using other instruments and accessories, perhaps not native to the Flair products themselves. This move does offer the user a far greater user experience and honestly, endless opportunities to try new things when brewing espresso with the Flair 58. One of the first things you might want to consider is a new filter basket. Not that there's anything wrong with the standard one that you get with the Flair 58, as it's an 18 gram low flow basket due to its narrowing profile. And Flair have already released their own version of a 20 gram high flow basket with a more straight and open profile. But there are loads of great manufacturers out there also making quality precision baskets. And along with the naked portafilter, you're not then really restrained to a maximum depth of the basket, and you could totally go a VST 25 gram basket, for example, or maybe you're brewing with lighter roasts, searching for higher yields and extractions, then I would highly recommend the rarely used but highly effective 15 gram VST basket. And within the standard filter basket, you can comfortably fit anywhere from 17 grams up to 20 grams. I'm going with 18 grams today, and I'm going to be aiming for 36 grams of espresso out. Now, the grind setting you would use with the Flair 58 is bang on true to any regular espresso machine's requirements. And with the included tamp, there's everything you need to start making great coffee, but a few extra tools can make brewing better coffee even easier. Now, once tamped, don't forget to add your puck screen on top of your tamped coffee with the Flair 58 logo facing up. And this is going to assist in the dispersion of water across the bed of coffee initially, but it also plays a crucial role in stopping any ground coffee being sucked up into the brew chamber at any point during the brewing process. Now, ensure the lever is pressed all the way down prior to locking in your portafilter. then go ahead and begin filling that brew chamber with close to boiling water above the piston and all the way to the top of the chamber. This holds a maximum of around 80 mils of water. From here, slowly bring the lever up and you'll notice the water will be sucked in under the piston and then into the brew chamber, ready to begin brewing. And if you're prepared, you already have a cup underneath. I'm also using a set of Akai Luna scales to weigh my espresso yield out. Now, it's the T-grip handle on this extended lever that makes a huge difference to the comfort and ease of pulling an espresso on the Flair 58. And me personally, I could almost get rid of any of the other additions and just keep this handle on the Flair 58, as it makes brewing so much more enjoyable. And the other of Flair's brewers, whilst I do love them dearly, I often feel like I'm wrestling with them a little bit just to get a shot out sometimes. Whereas the Flair 58 is like butter and there's little to no resistance on that lever, you're able to stand straight on with the brewer and then use one hand to pull the lever down more effectively. And the espresso that comes out of that bottomless portafilter, well, that almost speaks for itself. It just looks superb. And I like to begin with a slow buildup of pressure for a steady pre-infusion of that basket and then ramp up to somewhere between 7 to 9 bars for the rest of the extraction. And one of the great things about a lever machine is you feel that resistance directly in the lever, and the lever gets easier to move the further along the shot you go. And then this gives you the ability to just back it off a little bit, just a little bit at the end of the shot, so you're not over extracting it and you can still hit your target. And then I'm just going to lift the lever all the way up to the top when we get to where we're aiming for. That'll stop the shot and our espresso. It's dark, it's rich, it's full of crema and aromas. Now the taste test. Oh, yeah, that's delicious. That's great. I reckon on a blind test, I wouldn't know the difference between this and an espresso made on an actual espresso machine. But I think this could be even better. Perhaps I could lengthen the pre-infusion a little bit at the start, or even fine the grind up, I reckon, and then brew a little bit slower overall, or perhaps just brew more coffee out for more nuances in flavors. But this is the great thing about the Flair 58. You have those opportunities to tweak almost everything at once and then still maintain some balance within the shot, as you have control over all the elements. And if you didn't particularly like this coffee, let me show how easy it is to brew another shot. You simply need to add a cup under the group head and then press the lever all the way down on the previous shot until it foams out slightly from the filter basket. And this avoids a wet, messy puck when we're knocking it out later on. Don't forget to gather your puck screen before you knock out your filter basket. Then wipe the portafilter clean, dose some more coffee into your basket, add some water into the brew chamber, and you're ready to go again. And that's a quick and easy setup to be pumping out more shots from the Flair 58. Now, as a side note to the Flair 58, if you enjoy your coffee with milk, it's one of these two products you're gonna wanna get, either the Bellman 50SS Stovetop Steamer or the Subminimal Nanofoamer. Either one of these two is going to complete that package to have delicious flat whites, cappuccinos or lattes at your fingertips with no more lining up at a cafe, and you can completely forget about the expensive and tedious maintenance or even any sort of water filtration, if that doesn't sound fun to you, that comes with having an espresso machine at home and having to maintain it. Whilst breaking the Flair 58 down for maintenance can be done in minutes, and Flair only recommend cleaning everything with hot water rather than using any detergent on any of the parts. Then of course, wiping it all dry before placing it back together is a super simple way to keep the Flair 58 working for years to come. And that's the Flair 58 manual lever espresso machine for you. Now, if you haven't seen the full lineup of Flair's other brewers, then I do suggest you check those out, as you'll then see the evolution and the progress that has given us the Flair 58. And it certainly seems like we are reaching a pinnacle of what's the best manual lever espresso machine out there right now. And I think the biggest thing to cement the Flair 58 as that gold standard for this title to date is the universality of the 58mm portafilter. And whether that pinnacle has been reached or not, the Flair 58 certainly allows you to explore beyond that regular espresso brewing routine and brew some really amazing coffee. So if you have any questions on the Flair 58, add them in the comments section down below and we'll get straight back to you. Thanks for watching to the end of this video and we'll see you in the next one.